A federal judge blocking a California regulation that would have lowered greenhouse gas emissions. And Myron Ebell could not be more pleased because he says it's rules like this that kill jobs. Thank you so much for being on the show tonight, Myron. You know, Governor Schwarzenegger was for this rule. This would have been the first statewide cap and trade system in the country. Now it may be gone. It may not work. It may not even happen. What do you make of this?
Well, a federal judge has said that one part of California's set of laws to raise energy prices and destroy California's economy violates the Interstate Commerce Clause of the Constitution, and therefore it can't go into effect. So that could spread to other pieces of the law, and so they may have a problem implementing their plans to destroy California's economy.
Yeah. All right, Myron, let's get back to jobs. How would this bill have... what impact would it have had on jobs in the state of California?
Well, of course, if you raise energy prices, as this whole set of global warming laws is designed to do, to force people to use less energy, people will have less money in their pocket to spend on other things, but you'll also raise the price of manufacturing in the state. They've already destroyed a lot of the manufacturing in California, but there is still some left, and anything that these laws do to further raise energy prices will drive employment out of the state.
You know, here's the deal, too. When you enact a system like this, and we saw this in other parts of the world, notably in Europe, what happens is, and the voter is not aware of this, the taxpayer is not aware of this, government officials
right.
behind the scenes start jiggering and rejiggering the cap-and-trade system. And they do not understand the impact that it has on businesses in those parts of the world. What have you seen in other areas of the world where a cap-and-trade system was enacted? Was there corruption?
Well, the whole thing is designed for people who want to game the system and make money through you know, shady dealings. And in Europe, the cap and trade system has led to huge amounts of corruption. There are all kinds of court cases and criminal investigations going against people who have sold phony renewable certificates, carbon credits. The whole thing is based on sort of monopoly money, and obviously crooks and con men are flock to these kinds of things. So that of course is going to happen in California as well. This particular law is not cap and trade. It's the low carbon fuel standard for cars. It requires them to reduce the carbon content of gasoline, and that means, for example, that they're trying to keep out oil sands from Canada because they claim that the oil sands, it takes more energy to produce oil from those oil sands than it does from regular oil wells, and that increases the carbon content of the fuel. So this whole thing is designed to gum up not only local state commerce, but international commerce.
All right, Myron, so good to be with you tonight, sir. Thank you so much for your time. Really appreciate it.